అంతే మేడం, నాకు ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ త్రీ అంతే. ఎస్ కుమేష్ అండి.
హలో ఎవ్రీబడి, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ కృతికా. ఐఎమ్ అన్ అసిస్టెంట్ ప్రొఫెసర్ అట్ సెయింట్ మార్టిన్స్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ సికింద్రాబాద్. టుడే వి విల్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ద టాపిక్ బూలియన్ ఆల్జీబ్రా అండ్ లాజిక్ గేట్స్. బూలియన్ ఆల్జీబ్రా ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్జీబ్రా విచ్ ఇస్ యూస్ టు అనలైజ్ అండ్ సింప్లిఫై లాజిక్ గేట్స్ అండ్ సర్కిల్స్. సో ఇన్ దాట్ దే ఆర్ ది బేసిక్ గేట్స్ విచ్ వి యూజ్ విచ్ ఆర్ అండ్ ఆర్ అండ్ నాట్ గేట్. ఈ అండ్ గేట్ ఇస్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ ఫర్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్, ఆర్ గేట్ ఇస్ యూస్ ఫర్ అడిషన్ అండ్ నాట్ గేట్ ఇస్ యూస్ ఫర్ కాంప్లిమెంట్. Each of this gate has its own truth table and its own symbol. This AND gate has two inputs and it is represented like this. OR gate is represented as such and the NOT gate is represented as such. So these are the basic gates which we will use to design any logic circuit. So the truth table of an AND gate would be, it has two inputs and one output. And it is a multiplication operation. So, and the inputs would be only 0 and 1 since it is a binary operation which we are using. This is the truth table of an AND gate. As we can see here, both the inputs are multiplied with each other, and this is what the output we get. Similarly, for OR gate, we get the truth table as. This would be the truth table of an OR gate. This will represent the addition operation. And for a NOT gate, the simple truth. This would be the simple truth table. From this, we can say that whatever input would be at the NOT gate, the output would be the opposite of it. So before we go into the other logic gates, first we'll see the few laws which we use in Boolean algebra. There are basically 10 laws and we'll see each of them using an example as well. So the very first law which we'll see is the annulment law. It states that whenever a variable is multiplied, that is added with a 0, we get the output as 0. And whenever a variable, for example A, is odd with 1, we get the output as 1. This is the annulment law. So this is the first law which we will see. For example, if we take A to be 0, then we get 0.0 is 0. And the same for the other one, 0 plus 1 will be 1. This is what the annulment law states. Next, the second law is identity law. This law states that when a variable is odd with 1, we get the same variable. And when a variable is ANDed with 1, we get the same variable. And when the variable is odd with 1, also we get the same variable. Here also we can take an example. If A is 1, if A is 1, then 1 or 1 we get 1. Similarly, if A is equal to 1 here, if we substitute, then we get 1 plus 0 is 1. This is the identity law. Next, we look at the idempotent law. Next we'll dual negation. This law states that when a variable is complemented twice, that is, once a complement is taken, again its complement is taken, then we get the same variable. This can be represented as this. This is one complement, again this is complemented, then we get the same variable. Again, then if we take A is equal to 1 for example, one complement would be 0, again 0 complement would be 1. So from this we can state that the variable which we took as 1, we again got the same 1. Next, we can see the complement law. So this law states that when a variable is complemented and it is added, for example, we take A plus A bar, that is, A bar is the complement of A, then we get 1, and if it is or, if it is added with its complement, then we get 0. Here also we take example, if A is equal to 1, then we get A bar is equal to 0, so 1 plus 0 would be 1. Here 1 into 0 would be 0. So like this we can also tell about the complement law. Next we will see the commutative law. So this commutative law states that if two variables, for example if we take A and B, if they are ANDed or ORed, we need not consider the order in which they are ANDed or ORed. We can tell that like this, A plus B will be the same as B plus A. This is the OR operation. If we take A OR and B, it will be the same as B and A. So here basically the law states that we need not take care of the order in which the operation takes place. So next, next law is associative law. So for this law states that when we take two variables in a bracket, even if we interchange the variables in the bracket, the equation would not change. This is what the associative law states. It says that this equation would be equal to this equation even if the variables in the brackets would change, because the operation would be the same. Next, we'll see the distributive law. This is what the distributive law states. When we take three variables and the we apply and the OR operation between them. So the next one which we will be seeing is the absorption law. So this absorption law, this is how it is written. A plus AB will give us A. We'll prove this using an example. If we take A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. So we'll substitute these values in the above equation. So 0 plus 0 into 1, we'll get 0 plus 0. That will be 0. That is A, which we took. Similarly, we can also say A dot A plus B. We take the same variables here, 0 dot 0 plus 1, we'll get 0. This is what the absorption law is. Next we'll see the last law, which is the De Morgan's law.
We take 1 into 1,
which would be 1 and its complement will be C. So the output which we get is the same AND output. So this we can say that NAND is a universal gate. So now let us see the remaining two gates and XOR and XNOR gates. The basic equation of an XOR gate, if pi is the output, it is A bar B plus A B bar, and for XNOR gate it is, if pi is the output and the inputs are A and B, A B plus A bar B bar. And for the truth table we can use any kind of, we can use 1 or 0 and we can put them in this equation and we will get the truth table, and the truth table will be like this. Similarly, for an XNOR gate.